Yeah, hi guys, today we are going to look at review of probability distribution and data modeling. So probability distribution plays a vital role in the data modeling or analyzing the data or interpreting, so that we need to understand the probability distribution of the data first. So in order to understand that, there are few fundamentals we need to start with. Random variable, you would have heard in your childhood days, random variable. So that random variable deals with two types: discrete random variable, continuous random variable. Whenever you are looking at discrete random variable, one best example is normal distribution. Then whenever you are looking at a continuous random variable, it follows probability distribution. Vice versa. The moment you say continuous random variable, it follows probability distribution. Whenever you see probability occurrences, then it comes to the category continuous random variable. With that note, let us start. Let us take one example. The event that has more than one value, each value is associated with its probability or associated likelihood. Then this, I'm telling the chances of winning the game or the chances of rain, like that we are trying to predict. 0.5%, 0, 0.2%, 1, 0.3%, 2. So what here we can interpret, for example, some of you telling, I'm taking a survey. There is no rain at all, people pretend to tell. There are few people trying to tell partly raining or mild rain or drizzling will happen. There are few people telling today heavy rain would occur. So that I'm having some number of people, maybe 10 people, 20 people around me. I'm just having the question with each and everyone. So what is the probable answer they are giving? Depending upon that, I am taking it as 0, 1, 2. It could be categorical also. I can say no rain. I can say partly cloud or drizzling. Drizzling may happen. I can say this to us heavy rain. So that is what my surrounding people are trying to tell me. Based on the total number of people to whom I have interacted and how many people informed me that definitely no rain would happen, then I am calculating the probability. Only one event. My question is, today rain will come or not? That is only one small question I started asking to my neighborhood people. Then these are all the possible answers they are telling. In that also, there is no concrete. Everyone is telling different way. One of my neighborhood is telling no rain will come. Another one of my neighborhood is telling rain will come. That too, drizzling only will come. This is best example for random event or random variable. So this is the example you can start with. Intuitive principle. Whenever the probability comes, that probability comes means you need to think that it is of random nature. Randomly people are asking. No one can predict. So even today, if you look at around our institution, humidity is more, sweating is more. I am also predicting rain would come. The moment I have this question, if I approach my neighborhood people, how they are reacting to me? What are all the possible answers they are giving to me? Then I am finding the probability. 5 out of 10 is telling no rain, then 50% probability. Then remaining 50% are telling, there are 2 are telling there would be a drizzling. There are 3 are telling there would be a heavy rain. That is what I have put there. So this kind of one event only, whether rain will come or not, this is only one event. I am not mixing too many things, but that itself, lot of probable answers are coming. That is best example for random in nature or probability in nature. Next, types of distribution. This is the core concept we are going to discuss today. That is just an intuitive principle I am bringing for your understanding. Maybe discontinuity may be there for your studies. So that, what are all the possible distributions? Bernoulli distribution, uniform distribution, binomial distribution, normal distribution, Poisson distribution, exponential distribution. So these are all the distribution we need to understand when to use what distribution or what situation. This is all related to situations and occurrences. only then we can approach with appropriate distribution. So that let us understand one by one. Look at the very first one. We are going to start with Bernoulli distribution. Whenever Bernoulli distribution we are using, it will have only two chances, yes or no, success or failure, zero or one. For example, winning the match, India winning the match, cricket match. There is a cricket match, let us assume. Winning the match, never it would be 50% they will win, 10% they will win. There is no answer like that. Our team will win, our team will lose. Only two answers we have. Whenever this kind of situation will come, we can take it this as an example. Winning or not, pass or fail. See, the in your examination, the moment you write examination, there is no other fuzzy state. You will be declared as pass, or you, whether you are topper also, you are designated as pass candidate. You will be declared as fail. Even if you get zero also, you will be designated as fail, anything. So this only two occurrences. That comes into the category Bernoulli distribution. Tossing a coin, these all tail or head, these all example for Bernoulli distribution. So when it comes Bernoulli distribution, if you say this is the probability of occurrence, this P is probability of occurrence, then what is a Q that is not possible to occur is 1 minus P. These all our childhood mathematics, but we should know the appropriate terminology for our higher educational purpose, that is Bernoulli distribution. So this is what. Now finally, how this is coming? Say team 1, team 2, the probability of success or failure need not be equal also, but only two cases need not to be equal. What is the meaning here they are trying to tell? See, for example, you are conducting a survey. What they will be telling? How many people are trying to tell that Indian team will be winning? How many people are trying to tell that Indian team will not be winning? But number of occurrences only I'm telling two. It is only two. There is no other state. Pass or fail is only two. Then winning the match is only yes or no, or success or failure. Most of our day-to-day life circumstances are into two categories. But the probability of distribution may be different. How that probability of distribution comes is not based on that event, based on the opinion, or based on the survey, or based on the nature of circumstances. If you look at here, success rate would be 0.25, failure rate would 0.15, failure rate would be 0.85. This is what we are trying to predict before the match happens. Then this becomes Bernoulli distribution. Okay, that's all. So Bernoulli distribution, this is the game. You can consider this as a game. Team 1, team 2. We are trying to investigate, or we are trying to go for people polling. Polling time, we are trying to gather, even political election time, we will be having a pre-polling. Before the election happens, we will be having pre-polling. But the party winning or losing, only two cases. But here, what would happen? Pre-polling time, opinion. That opinion is going to be depicted like this. Okay. Now, how we can calculate? This is what the way you can calculate. Equations, equation form, or it is a kind of P and 1 minus P. That's it. There is no big concrete understanding in it. Next, coming to the next category of discussion, uniform distribution. What is this uniform distribution? Look at this uniform distribution. There is a ceiling, A and B, interval. Within that interval only will happen. For example, our college bus arrival to our institution, normally it would become 9 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. It happens all the time between these two intervals only. This is example for whenever it happens. The probability we are trying to find out, bus number A, B, C, 1A, 1B, something like that we have. So what is the probability of 1A arriving at 9 o'clock? What is the probability of 1A arriving late? So these are all those things we are trying to calculate. If not 9:30, you can exit or even 10 o'clock. There are few buses most often coming late. I have watched it. But there is an interval. within that interval only will be happening. Never the bus will be reaching our campus by 3 o'clock in the mid afternoon. Never the bus will be reaching by 12 o'clock in the mid afternoon. We all know that. 9:30, before 9:30, bus should park in our ground. If it is delayed, yeah, it goes up to 10 o'clock at the worst case. Not more than that. There are other things will happen, unusual circumstances due to accident or climate, whatever, it happens. That I agree. But most of the time, what is happening, that interval we need to fix. Even we ourselves predicting, this is the bus will come earlier, this is the bus will come later. So that all the probability we ourselves calculated. Whenever this situation comes, that is coming or falling into uniform distribution. That is what interval we are fixing. A and B we are fixing. Look at another example. This is our college bus arrival. Even public bus also, if you look at, we may be waiting for the bus at any one particular day. What is the probability of that bus to reach the terminus? Either it may reach 10 minutes before or it may come 10-15 minutes delayed. So the total interval would become 30. Even train arrival, we all have that, that interval. Beyond that also it happens, that I agree. But that rare incidents we cannot tell. That all bound to happen within that interval. Another thing is what? Uniform distribution. Your own mark sealed. You can get the worst mark 0. You can get the best mark 100. However you are good at. None of the teacher will be grading you more than 100. None of the teacher will be grading you negative. So this is another. The probability distribution of all of your mark within that interval only will happen. If I start calculating your mark and all the probability, then it will happen within that. Now let us look at one example. The number of bouquets sold daily at a flower shop is uniformly distributed with a maximum of 40 and the minimum of 10. So this is what ceiling. Imagine I'm running a bouquet shop. So daily I am observing, other than seasonal days, maybe festival days or local festival seasonal days, I am watching my business pattern. It runs maximum of 40 bouquets per day, 10 bouquets per day, with the minimum. This is what I am trying to predict in my past history. Now, probability calculation for daily sale between the range 15 to 30. Look at, I want to find out the probability of this, how much it is happening. Look at this. This falls within this interval. 10 is the minimum, 40 is the maximum. Here 15 is the minimum, 30 is the maximum. So again, I am calculating, trying to calculate within this interval only. Then it becomes uniform distribution. Look at, daily sales will fall between 15 and 30. How you can calculate? This is how you can calculate. A plus B divided by B. For this one, I didn't bring the formula. Yeah, you can calculate this. The maximum minus minimum into 1 divided by the interval. See, interval always we need to consider 1 divided by B minus C. This interval we are considering because that is what the pattern or tendency I'm observing. So that 1 divided by 40 minus 10, 30 minus 50. So this is the way you can calculate. So 50% of the time or 50% probability every day this is happening. It is for sure 50% of my business happening between the interval 15 to 30. Remaining 50% only, either it may go less than 15 or it may go greater than 30. That all rare circumstances or unusual pattern we can say. This is how you can calculate, given the scenario, what is the probable rate for all the possible combinations. Next, you can calculate for greater than 20. Daily sale which goes greater than 20. The moment you say 20, this would become minimum. Maximum would become 40. 40 minus 20 into 1 divided by 40 minus 10. That is a formula you can use it for calculation. Whenever you are given the scenario, you must in the position to pick up which kind of distribution it is. That is why we are understanding the distribution. Then after understanding the type of distribution only, we may need to choose the calculation or the rely on the formula. So that is the reason we need to understand each and every distribution. That's all. Next, this is the equation for what the distribution function for. 1 minute. Uniform distribution. So this is probability distribution function. Probability distribution function is PDF. This PDF is given this way. Whenever your probable values are going between 0 to 1, then you can say 1. Otherwise, you can say 0. That's all. Because you are giving the ceiling, then from that ceiling only, A and B interval, within that intervals only, you are trying to calculate. So whichever falls within that range, you can treat it as 1, otherwise it is 0. Next is binomial distribution. This is also a part, a type of Bernoulli distribution. Now, look at this, tossing a coin, two possible outcome, 0.5, 0.5. There is no other chances, 0.5, 0.5. So now, whenever you are trying to calculate binomial distribution, you can use this formula. For the number of trials only you need to go. For a single trial, it would be 0.5, 0.5, exactly 0.5, 0.5, no other option. Either you may end up with head or you may end up with tail whenever you are tossing a coin. So that 0.5, 0.5 equal probability, whenever equal probability, it is a binomial distribution. This is the only best case or best example. There is no more example, I think so, available for binomial distribution. Only the tossing the coin toss is the only available example, I think so, I'm not sure. So this is only 50-50% will come. No other probability will be there with 50, exactly 50-50. Next, coming to this binomial distribution. 1 minute. This is total number of identical trials. So for all the total number of trials, this is the distribution curve. Number of trials you are increasing, 1 trial, 2 trial, 3 trial, up to 11 trials. Next, coming to the normal distribution. Most of the natural phenomena will take normal distribution. Whenever you are looking into bell shape or Gaussian distribution or bell curve, this is the example, best example for normal distribution. When it comes normal distribution, if you look at any larger class, their mark, if you start distributing, there are few students always will fall below the pass mark. There are few students will score above the pass mark. Most of the students will be distributed between this band, not too higher, not too lower. They will be into exactly pass and up to 60. So this is one best example for normal distribution. Any data when we take larger in size, then naturally it follows normal distribution. That is what central limit theorem used to say. What central limit theorem says, samples should be more. More and more the samples, that means finally data points, more and more the samples, then distribution would become normal. That is what central limit theorem they say. Now when it comes machine learning and statistics, most of the tools working based on the underlying principle called normal distribution. If you are trying to go for correlation, if you are trying to calculate regression, so these are all the prediction or these are all the analysis expects data need to be in the normal distribution. This is what example for or purpose of normal distribution. Let us start with again. most of the natural phenomenons in the universe follows normal distribution. That is what scientists claim. They even investigated this with a lot of domains, lot of observations. That is what I'm trying to tell. Look at your own class. Otherwise, it is exemption. Section A. If you look at, there are around 100 students. Let us imagine in a class, there are 100 students. If you look at the mark, the pattern of roll number 1 to roll number 100, all the marks, if you try to distribute, if you try to plot, what will happen? It will take at least more or less, if not exact, more or less normal distribution. Especially when it becomes private institution, different quota, different sports quota, different norms of admissions are happening because of our government regulations. Naturally, the students' mark scoring would lead to normal distribution. If not because of quota, depending upon their motivation, self-motivation, every student tend to study differently. So they will be trying to get zero mark also, trying to get zero mark also. They're trying to get 100 marks also. So if you look at the spread of distribution, 80% of the time, students will be falling into the average band, close to each other. 60 marks, 65 marks, 68 marks, 70 marks, 70, close to each other. There are few students, they fall into tail, this side, left-hand side tail. For your direction, it is left-hand side. If you look at left-hand side tail, all the least marks, not necessarily to be negative. Normal distribution, you can try for positive also, negative also, mixing also. So they will fall into this tail, less than 50 marks. Then if you look at more than 50 or 60 marks, then there would be very minimal number of students. If you look at that distribution curve, more or less it will take normal distribution. If at all not a normal, that is exceptional class. That is where we used to say this class performance itself not good. Because if most of the students are going towards less than 50, then although it goes less than 50 also, it will take normal distribution. Not all the students will be taking zero. Not all the students will be scoring 49. Then among that pattern also, it would take normal distribution. That class seems to be worst. But even then, it will take normal distribution. Very few will be near zero. Very few will be near 50. Most of the students would become between this band. That is why most of the statistical tool, they are building, they are working based on the assumption normally distributed. So that during the pre-processing time, especially to the linear regression or logistic regression, we may need to normalize the data. That is a major pre-processing step in most of the data processing, because most of the tools and tool means the formulas. Whatever the formula we are using during machine learning, most of the tool is designed or working based on this underlying assumption called normal distribution. Okay. Now let us look at how they are trying to tell it is a normally distributed. Whenever you look at normal distribution, mean, mode, median will become close to each other. When it becomes close to each other, that is called normally distributed. If there is lot of differences among these three, based on the difference, either left skewed or right skewed, again that category will come. If median is greater than mean, if the median is less than mean, that combination leads to right skewed distribution or left skewed distribution will come. If all the three values are close to each other, then it becomes more or less bell shaped. So symmetrical, exactly x is equal to y if it happens. Now for the normal distribution or probability distribution function, for the normal distribution is this. Now look at the curve. Mean 0.4, standard deviation 1.5. this is the best example for normally distributed. Rest are all we cannot consider normally distributed. However, it takes a normal distribution pattern. The perfect distribution is only green color. Standard deviation is 1.5. Standard deviation is more means this width will become more and more. Standard deviation is lesser means this way. Look at the red color and blue color. Standard deviation is lesser, so that the width will become lesser. Similarly, if you look at mean 1.5, mean 1.4, mean 1.4. So although here also mean is 1.4, look at this is exactly falling into same line. That is why green and blue are falling into the mean value 0.4 same. The deviation only differs. Mean is shifted for the red color. Mean becomes 1.5. So this is how you need to interpret. So the deviation is more here. Since the deviation is more, it is taking exactly the bell curve or Gaussian distribution or normal distribution. Let us move on to this is standard. Standard normal distribution. See, this is an example for standard, perfect normal distribution. Whenever it is following standard normal distribution, there are few component will be vanishing here. Sigma is one of the component. See, sigma is another component, mu is another component. How that is going to vanish, let us look at. Mean becomes zero, deviation, standard deviation becomes one. Just go and substitute 0 and 1 in the place of mean and standard deviation. Then this formula would become this. That's all. So this is the formula for exact or standard normal distribution. This is one of the important underlying phenomena we need to understand. Always mean becomes 0 and standard deviation becomes 1. It is said to be standard normal distribution. Other than this combination, we can say normal distribution, not the standard normal distribution. Now, whenever you say standard normal distribution, the area under the curve is 1. What central limit theorem says? If that samples are more, then normal distribution is possible. This is what central limit theorem says. Okay, next. Coming to this, the moment we are stepping into normal distribution, then we may need to step into another word called confidence interval. What is a confidence interval? Let us see. Not only normal distribution, most of the statistical cases we need to work with confidence interval. Now look at now this is the next scenario. Confidence interval, what it signifies? I said in the beginning we will be working on samples, not on population, most of the time. See, for example, if you are going for social media analytics, if you are going for Amazon product review data analytics, any data you take, that data is treated as sample because it is going to become certain period, maybe 2015 to 2020, 2015, 2020. Something like that. Or we are not going to consider the future trend. We are going to take a sample data of 1 year, or the day you are going to web scrape, you are going to do the web scrape, that particular data only you are trying to take. So that is called sample. Most of the time we cannot do our work on population. The moment we are trying to consider sample, there is lot of chances of sampling error. What is the meaning of error is, for example, imagine in our institution, so far now, maybe VIP people, rich people, students are studying. If I calculate their annual income, it would be falling within, again, normally distributed. There are few students who would become more rich. There are few students who would become poor. Rest all would fit into middle category. Then what will happen sampling time? Imagine within 5 years, only VIP students are coming and studying. Then error would become more. Anything if I predict, based on the previous tendency of calculation, or whatever I have calculated or automated, based on that anything I try to work on with a new pattern of data, that leads to lot of error. That is where sampling error comes, because population exactly never it is possible, or never we can fit for the calculation, we can consider for the calculation. That is what in the previous class I said, Amazon business sale, it was different in the earlier case before this lockdown. After lockdown, 3 months no business at all happened with Amazon, especially in India. I don't know about other country. Then coming to slowly the lockdown release, slowly the business sale is becoming more. This is unusual pattern for their past history. So this is what I mean to say, sampling error. While training the model, what data we picked up, that leads to error. So now, what is confidence interval? Let us move on from the sampling error only. I can connect with this confidence interval. Most of the time, this confidence interval is trying to speak about degree of uncertainty or certainty. Certainty also you can talk, degree of uncertainty also you can talk. If you look at, if I say 95% confidence interval, you are talking about 95% of certainty, 5% of uncertainty. That is what this signifies. There are three confidence interval normally people used to consider. 1 minute, I'll take this one. Three types of confidence interval. 90% confidence, 90% confidence, 99% confidence error. Most of the ideal case people chooses 95% confidence interval. Why? Because error we cannot assure. Estimation error, this side also can go. Estimation plus margin of error, this end also may happen. This end also may happen. See, seasonal time, Amazon sale, let us consider seasonal time. This side error would happen more, because normally what is a sale pattern goes on, beyond that something great sale would happen. So when you are comparing with the earlier model prediction and towards a seasonal prediction, then margin of error would become more on this side. Look at lockdown side. There is no sale at all with Amazon, so that the error would become more on this side. That is the reason never statistically people will be telling 100% confidence interval. At the maximum, they will stop at 99%. Definitely there would be 1% of estimation error would happen. 1% of the prediction error would happen. Anything we can say. Estimation error leads to prediction error only. So all the error only leads to that, all the prediction error also. So because of that, we need to go for this confidence interval. Tight interval, 95% or higher confidence interval is idle. So what is tight interval is, look at this. 95% it happens between here to here, 2 sigma. Then rest all this 90%, then this becomes 95%. This happens dense. Within this, if you look at all the points or data points will be plotted here, scattered here. It will become dense here. Very few data only spreaded this towards this tail. That's what I'm telling students' mark score. 90% of the students will be falling into this band. Then another 5% would be falling into this band. The other 5% of students, 2.5 would be falling into this band. So this is what confidence interval. Next, why it comes is because of the margin of error. What is the margin of error? Never we can fit exactly with the population. What is population? The natural phenomena. Naturally, what will happen? We cannot predict. It is not possible. Sample only we can work on. From the sample only we are inferring for the population. That is what inferential statistics. So that never we can take or consider 100% interval. It is impossible. That is the reason maximum they have kept 99% interval. When you can take 99% interval, exactly if you are working on the population, no more data is possible on that particular problem statement or domain. That is the only data available in the entire world. Even the world is existing for another 100 years also, it will happen with the same pattern. If you are trying to define like that, then you can use 99% confidence interval. Otherwise, it is not possible to use 99% confidence interval. Any medicine, if it is discovered also, you can't tell 100% I can save the life of the patient for this particular cancer, because that patient may have multiple complications, nobody can assure. So never you can choose, especially medical domain, never you can choose 100% or 99% confidence interval. Any data, if you are trying to collect after drug administration and after observing the patient's reading or parameters, never you can think of 100% confidence interval. That is not statistically available, first of all. 99% itself, you cannot choose for especially medical domain. However, the medicine is wonderful. You can't set 99% sample, confidence interval. Not even 99, 95 also, it is not at all possible. Always when the medical domain, you can work with lesser confidence interval with more accuracy. You can set the confidence interval for medical domain 90%. That is my suggestion, because we are not working on complete sample. Error rate would become more, so that we can work with 90% confidence interval. That's all. Now coming to normal distribution, how you can interpret with a QQ plot? QQ plot says, or this is one of the validation matrices you will be considering with respect to, yeah. Coming to this QQ plot, you should be in the position to interpret based on normal distribution. Look at this. Whenever this takes perfectly normally distributed, this is the exact example for perfectly normally distributed. There is a confidence interval, that black color line, they will fix it as a confidence interval. If you look at all the data point, either it should align with the green color line, or it should fit within that confidence interval. Whenever this lines up, what that all the plots, data points we are trying to plot through data sample quantiles, we are trying to plot. If it takes exact alignment with that green color line, any package you use, there will be one solid line. Then if it is around that, then within the confidence interval, then you can say that it is normally distributed. See, this is data too peaked in the middle, too much of peak. Normally distributed, but the peak is more. It is not like this, no density. It is taking the curve like this, so that it is altered. Whenever QQ plot is not with the alignment, you need to go for pre-processing, you need to revisit the data, you need to do something with the data, or you need to normalize the data, anything you can do, but somehow you need to see to that this kind of fitting. QQ plot should become like this. This is what perfect or exact model, we can say, with respect to model. When it comes skewed data, the pattern would become like this. Now we no need to worry about other patterns. At least we should be thorough on what is the kind of QQ plot is valid. This is the exact QQ plot for perfect model. Rest all other plot represents there is a need of treatment or cleaning or pre-processing or data mounting or data transmission is required. This is the significance. If you want to go further in detail, you can understand if this is deviated in this pattern from the solid line, then what that signifies. If it is taking this quadratic curve like or a slight bend curve like, then what that signifies. You can go for further understanding. Nothing wrong in it. If this takes this pattern, it is called rightly skewed. The tail is on the right hand side, so that it is rightly skewed. So that is the significance. Then when it becomes here, if the pattern is like this, that signifies it is peaked, too peaked, highly peaked. This is what you may need to be thorough on normal distribution. In addition to understanding a common normal distribution, where it is useful, why it is useful, how this normal distribution is related with the confidence interval. These are all those points you may need to understand. Then coming to Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution, we may not able to predict precisely, we can't tell. What is the meaning? Look at this. The number of emergency calls recorded at a hospital in a day. Hospital is running for saving the people, but not necessarily every day there should be emergency call for ambulance. There are few days without call for ambulance also hospitals would be running. Or there are few days more number of calls, but you can't predict. Like my bouquet sale, you can't fix my bouquet sale would happen between this to this, like that you can't fix. The moment you can't fix, then it becomes Poisson distribution. See, number of theft reported in an area on a day to the police station. You and me cannot predict. You can't fix the interval. In this area, there are 3 theft cases. Every day is happening. Every day will happen. You can't fix. Those are all fall into Poisson distribution. Next, number of printing errors at each page of the book. You can't fix. There may be first 100 pages without error also author would have written. Right from 100th page to 150th page, there may be lot of error. Then after that also, there would not be error. So we can't decide. So this all nature will come into. Number of customers arriving at a saloon in hour. Number of theft reported to the police station in that particular area on a day. We can't sit and predict. These all comes into Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution, the probability mass function, that is probability density function. Now we are coming to probability mass function for the follows this equation or this method for the Poisson distribution. This is what Poisson distribution. What is the finally? Look at this, also looks like normal distribution, but you can't say it happens sometimes zero also. Many days it can be zero. Here the peak can go and it can fall and it can take different pattern. So this is what Poisson distribution. Nothing we can predict. It can be in any pattern. See here, look at most of the days into zero. All of a sudden it comes one. This is what Poisson distribution. Next, exponential distribution. Length of time between metro arrivals. The life of an air conditioner. These all follows exponential distribution. Exponential distribution will take this pattern. Whenever you are trying to do scatter plot, if it takes of this pattern, then it is termed as exponential distribution. Why we need to understand this distribution is the first question. So whenever you are trying to go for modeling, you may need to look at the data distribution. We need to understand what is the pattern of distribution. Only then we can use appropriate transmission technique for the transmission towards the normal distribution, especially linear regression expects normally distributed, so that we can bring back or bring to the normal distribution. For that, first we need to understand what is originally distributed, then what is the kind of technique we can apply. We can transform. Whenever it becomes binomial distribution, you cannot think of normal distribution and all. That all binary, one or two, categorical. Bernoulli, one or two. Binomial, one or two. That all becomes categorical. So that either this or probability. That moment you no need to worry of that distribution. Rest all the data, you may need to understand the distribution pattern. Then what kind of transformation technique we can apply for this data in order to bring to the normal distribution pattern. That is one method. Another method, given the scenario, they will be giving the scenario. Or like there are few scenarios we have seen, no? These are all the scenarios. Then how we need to calculate that, understanding the scenario, we may need to understand these are all the distributions fall into which category. Only then you can prefer the formula to work on that pattern. Okay, next, joint distribution. Joint distribution is one example for joint distribution is cross tabulation. So doing cross tabulation, what is the meaning of cross tabulation? I want to do pass or fail. I want to understand the frequency count. Frequency count is also frequency distribution. Female, who is more failure in the department I want to do? Fail, female, 50. Out of 200, let us say, for example. Fail, male, 40. And pass. Then what would happen? Then I should know number of female also, number of male also. If I try calculating based on two conditions, fail, female, fail, male, pass, female, pass, male, then it is termed as cross tabulation. Distribution, finding the distribution among the categorical or instances. Why we need to do distribution? There is another case. Look at this. All of a sudden I'm getting a data. This data is missing. Then missing value, it is possible to find out through distribution plot or frequency distribution plot visualization. From this, I can interpret what would become this value, more or less. Based on this distribution, the missing value is possible to find out. Or imputation, we can say missing value filling or missing value imputation. This distribution somehow helps to predict the missing value based on the pattern of the distribution. If it is exponentially distributed, only one value is missing, then that formula I can use, I can start imputing. Missing value treatment also, this distribution helps a lot. So these are all the applications of distribution. Are statistically, when we solve the problem, given the scenario, we need to understand what distribution it follows. Only then we can choose an appropriate formula for the calculation.